If you're working at all with Salesforce, you're going to need to know about profiles. Profiles define how users access objects and data and what they can do within Salesforce. Every time you create a new user, you assign them a profile. But that doesn't mean that you need a brand new profile for every user. You might actually have 10 different users who all are using the same profile. This is often the way that we assign profiles to users because profiles control a user's access in Salesforce, and so we often want to group users together who need the same levels of access. For example, you might have a sales rep profile for all of your sales reps, which gives them all the same access to leads, to opportunities, to accounts, but maybe not to campaigns or invoices. That's not really their cup of tea. You might have another profile for your support team, which gives them access to cases and contacts, but not to leads and opportunities. They don't need to see that. That's just for the sales team. Profiles are a fantastic way to manage not just what users can see, but also what they can do. Can they create certain objects? Can they edit certain fields? Can they delete anything? There's tons of different settings in a profile, but they can be roughly categorized into the following groups. The first group is object permissions, which we can use the acronym CRED for. CRED stands for Create, Read, Edit, Delete. The second group is field level security. This is where we can find all of the settings around hiding or showing certain fields on an object. Our third group is page layout visibility. What page layouts can this user see in Salesforce? Record type settings is next. Which record types for each object can a user see? Tab settings, of course, super important. Which tabs can a Salesforce user see when they first log in? Then app settings, again, which apps do they have access to? And there's also a bunch of admin and just general user permissions, which you can set here as well. This includes things that we've talked about already, passwords, login policies, session timeouts, all of that good stuff. There are two broad types of profiles, standard and custom. Standard profiles are ones that Salesforce has already created. They exist in Salesforce completely out of the box and are often really great starting points for you to create your own custom profile. If you do want to assign a user a standard profile, the profiles that you can choose from depend largely on which license your user has. If they have a very restrictive license, then Salesforce will give you a very limited number of standard profiles to choose from. If they have a full Salesforce license, access to everything in the org, then the amount of profiles that you can choose from is pretty much endless. Creating a custom profile is very, very common and easy to do. You can either create a profile from scratch, which honestly I wouldn't recommend unless you're being very, very restrictive on your settings, or you can clone an existing profile. Cloning an existing profile simply copies it exactly and gives you a great base which you can turn off or turn on settings that you need for that particular type of user. It saves you a lot of time and you don't have to be as fiddly and pedantic as if you were setting it up yourself from scratch. If you ever want to edit a profile, whether it's a standard profile or a custom one that you've made yourself, you can do so by simply clicking on the edit button for each profile. You can see which users are assigned to which profile by selecting the View Users button, or you can just go to that user's account page and see which profile they have from there. The best practice for profiles is to try and limit the total number of profiles that you can create. Avoid creating a brand new profile for one person, especially if they have similar permissions or access requirements to someone else. One profile should really be able to serve multiple users at once. If you have too many profiles, it can be really difficult to manage them all, and you'll easily lose track of what security and access different users have. This can obviously be quite a security risk. Profiles can seem like a huge lump of different settings and permissions, but they are a vital part of any system admin's toolbox and are easy enough to get the hang of with practice. If there's ever a problem with a user being able to see certain things in Salesforce or do certain things in Salesforce, checking out their profile is a really good place to start.